you think you're doing?
I just want to borrow it.
But it's mine.
You haven't touched it for months.
It's still mine, just for a couple of days.
What's it worth? What do you want for it?
I don't know yet, but it better be something good.
Spike, aren't you supposed to be looking after Banjo today?
I have been.
It doesn't look like it to me.
That's because Marion's doing it.
I am?
Yeah. I lend you the wheel. You look after Banjo. That was the deal.
It was?
Yeah, we shook on it. Remember? Like this.
But I've got a school project to do. I'm going to Abby's place.
Can't back out now. You've shooken on it.
Look, I've got jobs to do. Can you two just make up your mind?
Okay. Where is he then?
What do you think of this, Marian?
Where'd you get that?
Oh, they've given me 2 weeks off the community service program. So I thought I'd borrow this little baby.
Ah, to make some money.
That's the idea. Should be worth a few bucks to tidy up the neighbour's trees.
Great.
Banjo, you're with me today. We're going to Abby's place. Come on.
Hey, keep an eye out for that mother of hers.
Yeah, we'll be right. Come on, I'm late. Abby will murder me. Come on.
Where have you been?
Sorry, I had to pick up Banjo. Spike wouldn't lend us the wheel otherwise.
Get outside, you naughty dog. Go on, shoot.
Snobs!
I'll get him. Meet you out the back. Snobs, you go with Marian, okay?
There you go, mate. Enjoy the ride. You should mind your manners, Snobs. Banjo, you take Snobs and go and play in the yard, okay? But don't go over the fence. Go on then.
Have a look at my design. What do you think?
Great. We'll have the best bird catcher around.
Catcher? Don't you mean feeder?
Well, if we're going to all this trouble to feed them, we might as well catch them while we're at it.
It's against the law to catch native birds.
Yeah, I know. I'm just talking about pigeons and stuff.
Why would you want to catch pigeons?
Ever tasted pigeon pie?
Marian.
Abby, I'm going to take some things down to the charity shop. And you, make sure that dog of yours stays outside while I'm gone.
Okay, Mrs. Waltston.
Shan't be long.
We are not going to make a bird catcher.
Okay, okay. It was just a suggestion. Give us a hand with this, will you?
You silly little boy. You could have been killed. Listen to me when I speak to you. That was very stupid, do you hear?
Banjo, is he okay?
He's all right. It's me that's nearly had a heart attack. Little idiot ran straight in front of my car.
He's not an idiot.
Well, he most certainly behaved like one.
He's not an idiot, Grant. He's deaf.
Deaf? In that case, you should keep a closer eye on him when you take him out.
I'm really sorry, Mrs. Walston.
Oh, you gave us all a bit of a fright, didn't you? How long has he been like this?
Since he was born.
Why doesn't he use a hearing aid?
Dad says he's fine as he is.
What?
He says Banjo is Banjo. He was born deaf and that's the way he's meant to be.
You can't be serious.
It's what the Freeman believe, Grant. They say you shouldn't interfere with the way nature made you.
Do they just? Well, perhaps your father and I should have a little chat tomorrow.
That should suit Banjo to a T. What do you reckon?
Beauty.
Where is he?
Down the beach. I'll take it to him for you.
Morning, Tobar.
Oh, Mrs. Walston. We don't see you here too often. It must be important.
It is, actually.
Oh. Right.
It's a simple test, Tobar. Just to see if he can be helped, that's all.
He doesn't need help. He's fine the way he is.
Well, he wouldn't be fine if I'd run over him. He'd be seriously hurt, possibly even dead.
But you didn't run over him, did you?
Why are you being so pig-headed? Why won't you give the boy a chance to lead a normal life?
Let me tell you something. Banjo is our boy. He's deaf because that's the way nature made him. And neither you nor anyone else is going to put wires in his head or stick bugs in his ears. Do I make myself clear?
Perfectly.
It's our way, Gwen. It doesn't do to interfere.
You're living in the past, Gizzy.
And that's the way we like it.
You should think about your boy.
I am.
There you go, mate. A throne fit for a king. Do you like your chair? I'll go find Marian. He's got to see this.
Oi! Hey, Banjo. Got a nice new chair. Oh, what's the matter? You want your baby chair back?
Yeah, because if you want it, better jump.
Come on, jump!
You get it, Banjo?
Jump, Banjo!
Yep. Over here.
Girl, come on, jump!
Oh, is it too high?
You're too small?
Maybe you just have to jump?
Come on, just jump for it.
Come on, come on.
You want it, do you? You want it?
Hey, leave him alone! Yeah, you got some on your own side.
Nice, go!
Come back here, you scumbags.
It's okay, Banjo. They've gone now.
Rotten cowards. It's not fair that they pick on him.
Why do you think they pick on him?
Because he's deaf, of course.
So...
So what?
So why can't you help him? Why can't he have a hearing aid or at least a test?
Abby...
What if he was blind and there was a way to make him see? What would you do then?
That'd be different.
How?
Look, Abby, it's not my fault that Banjo's deaf.
But it is your fault if there's a way to help him and you do nothing about it. It's your choice, Marian.
I'm glad to see you, Marian. I wasn't sure you'd come.
I wasn't sure if you'd be here. If Dad found out...
Oh, let's not even think about that. Jump in. Oh, no dogs in my car.
Not even Snobs?
Not even Snobs. Marian and Banjo.
What?
In her car. I saw them getting in.
Interfering old crow. Where's she taking them?
Not for an ice cream, that's for sure.
It's all right, mate. I'm here with you.
He's profoundly deaf.
What does that mean?
Bluntly, it means he can't hear a thing.
Surely there must be something you can do.
Possibly.
What does that mean?
Well...
Snobs?
Excuse me. What the hell is this dog doing here?
Oh, he's my dog.
Well, grab him, will you? Grab him. I want you to sit down there, hold the dog, and do not move.
Great dog. What's its name?
Snobs.
Can I pat him?
Are you deaf?
Yeah. Can I pat Snobs?
And how come you can hear me?
I got one of these.
What's that?
It's a speech processor for my implant.
And it makes you hear, right?
Yeah, sure.
Can I borrow it?
What for?
To show my brother. Just for a couple of minutes.
I don't know. I can't hear without it.
You can look after Snobs for me. Oh.
Deal.
Stay. Be friends. Hey, Banjo, look at this. See, it's right next to his ear. Why won't it stick?
This is what I've been talking about. This is like a bionic ear. It sends the sound straight to the brain.
Well, didn't work.
Oh, this is just the outside piece. The implant has to be put inside his head.
How?
A long and complicated operation.
What operation?
Who are you?
Their father. Though you wouldn't think it.
Well, I was just explaining to the boy's grandmother.
Their grandmother, eh? Will you carry on explaining to their grandmother? He's coming home with me.
But Dad, he's got something that can make Banjo hear.
He doesn't need anything to make him hear.
Toba, could you please just let the doctor explain?
I don't need anything from the doctor. Can you just make sure that Marian gets back to the camp? Then you can start explaining.
This implant, would it really work?
Provided it's done soon, yes.
How soon?
In the next 6 months. The older he gets, the less effective it's likely to be. I think the big problem, though, is going to be your father.
Don't you ever, ever go behind my back again.
No, Dad.
You're a Freeman. Freemen stick together on everything.
Yes, Dad.
You're grounded, Marian. You only leave this camp to go to school. Now get out of here. And you are not to walk, talk, see, or go anywhere near Abby Oakley.
But Dad!
No buts. And don't go within a mile of that interfering old baggage of a grandmother either. Marian? I know you think you were doing the right thing for Banjo, but our family's lived by rules for nearly 200 years. They're good rules. They've served us well. You have to respect them.
Come on, Snobs.
No, Snobs stays with me.
But Snobs hasn't done anything.
He's going to do what you can't. Help me look after Banjo. Come on, boy. Oi, Snobs.
Hi, Marian. How did it go at home? He can't talk to you.
What?
Toba says you're off limits.
I'm grounded. I'm not allowed to see you or your grandmother.
You're kidding.
And Pia has to show my dad if I do.
What about the bird feeder? You'll both have to find another project. But that's not fair.
Sorry.
Right, mate. You take this and play with Snobs, okay? Now, stay in the garden and don't go near the road, all right? Off you go then. Come on. Off you go. mate.
Abby? Abby Oakley.
What's wrong, Mrs. Chet?
Where's Marian? I can't find him anywhere.
I haven't seen him. Have you asked Spike or Pia?
They don't know either. No one does.
What's happened?
His brother's had an accident.
Banjo?
He's been taken to hospital. It's quite serious.
It's terrible.
We have to let Marian know.
I'll find him.
Understand how you didn't see him.
I'm sorry, Rose. I was just concentrating on what I was doing.
Mum, where's Banjo?
Dad.
I'm all right, mate. Just a bit of a slip, that's all.
And Banjo?
He got hit by a branch. It got him in the head.
But he's all right, isn't he? Well, isn't he?
We hope so.
What do you mean?
The branch knocked him out. He hasn't woken up yet.
Hey, Banjo.
Will he be okay?
Well, there are no bones broken, which is a minor miracle considering the crack he's had on his head. But he is severely concussed, and underneath that bandage is one heck of a gash.
How long will he be like this?
Don't know. We just have to wait.
I'd like to stay here with him, if that's all right.
Oh, please, please do. He's bound to be frightened when he wakes up, and because he can't hear, we can't explain what's going on.
You go and help your dad. I'll look after Banjo.
See you tomorrow, Banjo.
Go and ask. Go on.
You go.
Spike, he's not going to bite.
Well, then why don't you go and ask?
Hi, guys.
Spike?
We just wanted to know how Banjo was.
We're not sure. Hopefully he'll be fine tomorrow.
No thanks to you.
Look, Marian, I didn't mean to.
What? Drop a tree on his head?
Of course not.
It was an accident, Marian. These things happen.
They wouldn't happen if he could hear.
But he can't hear, can he?
Well, he could if he had one of those implants.
A what?
Banjo could have something that could make him hear. If he wasn't so pig-headed.
What's he on about?
Hi. I brought some chocolates for Banjo.
Thanks, Abby.
Is the news good?
We don't know. We're seeing him tomorrow.
Can I come?
How is he?
I think you should see for yourselves.
Banjo, you're looking great.
He woke up about half an hour ago, and all he wanted was ice cream.
Two slow Snobs.
Yes.
Marian!
Hurry, hurry!
What are you doing here?
I've got something to show you.
What?
You'll see. Come on.
A beauty.
Gran helped me finish it.
It's the best catcher I've ever seen.
Feed her, okay?
Okay, feed her.
It can still be our combined project, if you want.
But you did all the work.
You got all the parts. Deal?
Deal. How'd you get her down here?
Gran brought me.
So where is she?
She wanted to see your dad.
Why?
Why do you think?
You really think this implant will make Banjo hear?
That's what the doctor says.
But he needs an operation.
Thousands of kids have had it.
So there's no risk then?
There's always a risk. But the doctor assures me it's very small.
I'd love Banjo to be able to hear. It'd make his life so much better.
It's your decision, Toba.
What about the cost?
The operation itself is free. However, he would have to stay on here at Eden Beach for about 6 months. He'll need care.
How will we pay for that? We don't have that kind of money.
But I do.
I don't want charity.
It's not for you. It's for Banjo.
No charity.
I have some land next to my house that's gone wild. It's a bushfire waiting to happen.
So?
We'll barter. You clear out the bush, and I'll foot the bill.
Dr. Snobs. Yeah! Nice one, Banjo. Catch him, catch him.
Well?
Look out for Snobs and his friends when they return to Impaja Monday afternoon at 4:30. Next, The Price is Right, followed by Neighbours.